The turbulence caused by the global financial crisis has understandably placed financial markets and their institutions under the spotlight, with searching questions being asked about their role and conduct. This increased scrutiny has led to calls for tighter internal and external governance to ensure more structured, efficient, and fair markets. The guiding principle behind these initiatives is to bring greater transparency to the markets, which has been Platts' core mission as an oil price reporting agency since 1909. Today, we provide professionals around the globe with oil news, commentary, market data, analysis, and thousands of daily price assessments, a term we use to refer to the market value we publish for commodities. Our price assessments are used as a basis for pricing spot transactions and long-term contracts, to identify patterns in supply and demand, and to protect against risk. Market participants choose to adopt many of our price assessments as industry standard benchmarks. A key distinction here is that Platts does not set oil prices. We provide price assessments for the market to make its own judgments as to oil's market value. As a neutral market observer, our independence means we have no vested interest in the price or value of oil, or where the market is heading. Platts' source of revenue comes from subscriptions to our range of market data, assessments, news and analysis services, licensing our assessments for use in financial instruments, and from conferences and events. To arrive at our price assessments, since the 1990s, we've been using our market on close price assessment process in dozens of crude oil and oil products markets worldwide. Not to be confused with an exchange, MOC exists to report, observe, and assess bids, offers, and trades. With increasingly volatile markets, Platts believes that the most useful price for the day is the value at the close of the market, just like the stock markets. As such, the MOC process is based upon the guiding principle that price is a function of time. Timestamping our assessments in this way fully reflects outright prices and relative values. It also allows for genuine comparison of valuations in other relevant commodity markets, and for mark-to-market and value-at-risk accounting. While the market is typically most active in the period of time before close, MOC involves Platts editors tracking the market continually. Throughout the day, they collect named bids, offers, and transactions by participants in the physical spot markets and publish them in real time. MOC participants can also enter and view bids, offers, and transaction data using our online communications tool eWindow, which brings even greater speed, efficiency, and transparency to the process. After market close, Platts editors analyze the data gathered, combining insight, judgment, and mathematical analysis to complete the process. Applying our publicly available methodologies, they rigorously adhere to strict guidelines that are accepted by all MOC participants. Crucially, these guidelines enable us to eliminate inputs that aren't verifiable, avoid price gapping, and identify data that is off-market, thus preventing distortion of the final price assessment. So when Platts publishes a final price assessment, it is transparent, fully verifiable, and reflects Platts' impartial view of the end-of-day value. And because it's about quality rather than quantity of data, our methodology guidelines also govern who participates in MOC. To date, everyone from major international oil companies to end users such as airlines has taken part in our rigorous vetting process designed to protect MOC's integrity and transparency. Platts offices around the world hold regular complimentary oil price assessment methodology events for anyone wishing to learn more about the process. Our constant evaluation of the MOC process is reflective of all our business activities to develop and improve our standards of governance further still. In 2002, we became the first PRA to establish a compliance function independent of our editorial and price reporting staff. And for some time, we have also been working closely with the International Organization of Securities Commissions as it developed its principles for PRAs. By October 2013, we will demonstrate that our business operates in accordance with the robust governance and control system set out in IOSCO's principles, including conflicts of interest policies and written complaints procedures, through an external assurance review conducted by a major audit firm. While we embrace strong processes and procedures, we also believe a balanced approach, as demonstrated by IOSCO, is required to ensure the effective functioning of the markets we cover. We would caution against oversight that could inhibit voluntary submissions of data by market participants and potentially affect the quality of price assessments. Our collaboration with IOSCO and focus on governance therefore began well before the LIBOR scandal and the recent European Commission inquiry. It is important to note here that commodity price assessments bear no relation to LIBOR. LIBOR rates are determined by a single source to reflect banks' daily estimates of their borrowing costs, while commodity price assessments are developed by independent competing price reporting agencies like Platts, who have no vested interest in the oil and energy markets. Another common misconception is that our crude oil benchmarks directly affect price at the pumps. Retail gas prices, which we don't report on, typically reflect crude oil prices at wholesale and are ultimately influenced by additional costs such as shipping, storage, state, local and federal or government fees and taxes. We hope we have gone some way to answering your questions about Platts' role in the commodity markets and welcome the opportunity to interact with policymakers and regulators as they consider these important issues. If you would like more information on our price reporting process and methodologies, further details can be found at platts.com, or feel free to email us.